was 39 years ago, this June, when I, as a young teenage lad, accompanied my older brother John to Ridgecrest for the first time. That experience changed both of our lives. John, who was enrolled at the law school at Yale University, gave his life for Christian ministry that summer and went on to Southern Seminary. And I began a new walk with the Lord. The music that I heard at Ridgecrest, both that week and the weeks and years that followed, made me want to become a part of the kinds of music that were played and sung at Ridgecrest. And since that time, many, many doors have been opened to share the good news as a singer of songs. And to you, many of you here tonight, Dr. Reynolds and his associates, ministers of music, musicians in our churches, colleges, and seminaries, I owe a great deal of gratitude because of your inspiration and encouragement through the years. Tonight, we do want to share with you music that speaks to this relationship of the Christian community, and most importantly, the relationship that we have with our Heavenly Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ. From Genesis, the first chapter, we read, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And God said, 'Let us make man in our own image, after our likeness.' And God saw everything that He had made, and behold, it was very good. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling of thunder. Goodness and mercy gave us a life made in His image, after His likeness. What an act of faith, of love and mercy on God's part. But you will recall that soon man transgressed God's law, and man was alienated from God. But God, the loving Father, never ceased to seek man's return, calling upon him to repent and to turn from his evil ways. The prophets of the Old Testament, among those Elijah and Obadiah, constantly urged a return to God. From Felix Mendelssohn's oratorio, the Elijah, the recitative and aria, "If with all your hearts." Ye people, rend your hearts, rend your hearts, and not your garments, for your transgression the prophet Elijah has sealed the heavens through the word of God. I therefore say to ye, forsake your idols, return to God.
gracious and repent him of the evil. If with all your heart ye truly seek me, ye shall ever surely find.
And so it was that Jesus was born in Bethlehem, fulfilling the prophecy made centuries prior to his coming. It was so difficult for the people of Jesus' day to accept him in the manner in which he came, in a lowly manger, just as it remains difficult today for people to accept him as the Messiah and Lord and Master of their lives. It's John the Apostle who wrote, "He was in the world, but the world, though it owed its being to him, did not accept him. He came unto his own, and his own received him not."
Sweet little Jesus boy, they made you be born in a sweet little holy child, didn't know who you was, didn't know you'd come to save us, Lord, to take our sins away. Thank you.
Last night, as Dr. Reynolds was leading this congregation and this wonderful choir of ministers of music, I couldn't help but think of what heaven must be when we can all join together in singing hallelujahs and praises to our Heavenly Father in the holy city.
From heaven. My gratitude, all that I have. than ever hoped to be. I owe it all to thee. God be the glory. God be the glory. God be the glory.
Thank you.